go into a nice arm stretch. Just rocking back and forth, and letting the weight of the person dangle a little bit so it stretches the arm down. Working. Side. So now we're going to start by doing some sustained stretch to help engage the fascia of the arms, right? So just leaning back with your body weight, taking up the slack. Let the joints start to open, the fascia start to burn. Exactly. That's what happens when it's restricted. And I'm just slowly rotating the palm up. Try to open the body up. Because when it contracts, it rolls towards the center. And releasing. And we're just going to come up. Use the palm of the hand right on the inside of the head of the humerus and the upper fibers of pec. And I'm going to push back. And then here's the concept of keeping your arm extended and then bringing your weight over like we did before for the arms. We're loosening. So the weight is coming down. So we're adding the meridians. That's what's different when we do like we did the arms before. So now I'm gonna just push here and just do some nice compression. And compression and bringing the arm down to help unroll the coracoid brachialis and one of the heads of the bicep. So compressing, coming to the elbow joint and just holding it, leaning here. This helps open up the carpals. So I'm pinning and I'm leaning to the side, opening up the carpals. Feel okay?
I just wanted to see.
I know, that's why you opened your eyes. Good. That's a good one to know. Okay. So now, compressing, now we're going to compress here. All right. And depending on the person's tightness, you know, you can use your palm. I use my knee quite a bit, my outside knee. So it's a controlled press. So you're coming from your center. So it's a you ease your weight in. And you bring awareness to your patella so you can feel what you're feeling. So like anywhere else, when you're pushing in and then you start to feel some resistance, stop. You come from center so you can feel that easily. Nice control. And just take it to just before you get to the wrist. And when I get to the wrist, I'm going to put my fingers behind the wrist and push up into the joint to help create a little bit more space in the carpal. So coming in and there's pressing. Okay, not too much. I'm just going to work the palm. Now, we're going to do three of the yin meridians of the arm, okay? And the three yin meridians of the arm are the lung, the pericardium, and the heart. The lung meridian starts just below the clavicle, to the lateral side, and it comes over the deltoid, and it goes through the bicep and the tricep on the thumb side. And that's all the time I have today, students. It was really nice spending the time with you. Yeah, that's just how it goes. And it comes like this, and it goes right between the bicep and the tricep, and right on the inside of the brachioradialis, and right up through the thenar eminence, and right out the thumb. So it's this. So when you do anything like this, you're stretching lung meridian, right? Because you're opening this up, you're stretching this. When you stretch, you can feel the stretch, you're opening up the meridian. The next one is the pericardium meridian, the protective sac around the heart. And it starts in the fourth intercostal space, and it comes up and it follows the contour of the pec, and it comes right through the center of the bicep and right through the center of the palm and right out the middle finger. And the last yin meridian of the arm is the heart meridian, which starts in the armpit, and it goes in the space between the bicep and the tricep. And again, it's a nice, relatively straight line right up in between the fourth and fifth metacarpals and comes up the fourth finger. So we're going to trace them by thumbing them. So for the lung meridian, starts below the clavicle, so you just do a little compression. And it comes around the the deltoid, and it comes in between the bicep and the tricep on the thumb side. So if you place the arm like this, you go right into this trough. You can feel it on yourself if you like. That space in between the bicep and the tricep on the thumb side. And then it comes down on the forearm, and it comes right on the inside of the brachial radialis. And it comes right onto the wrist crease, and right through the thenar eminence, base of the thumb, right up the side of the thumb, and it ends in the corner, the lower corner of the nail. So we're just going to thumb that whole line. Okay? And then, and you can use your manuals when you're doing it too, if it puts your mind at ease a little bit, no problem. The pericardium meridian starts in the fourth intercostal space, and it comes up and it follows the outer contour of the pec, and then it comes right through the bicep. So you can come right through into between the heads of the bicep, and if you're not sure how to do that, one thing I found helpful is if you push the bicep together and then push right down the middle, you'll go right in between the heads, right to the bone. So you can smoosh up, coast down. And just go right in between the bicep heads. And then it comes right through the center of the forearm in a nice, relatively direct line. And again, right through the wrist crease and right through the center of the palm. And it goes out the middle finger, so it's a nice straight line. And what's the benefit of bringing this specificity to the meridians, you may ask? Well, I mean, like we were talking about earlier, you know, every meridian has a particular function. It has a physical function and an emotional function. So, and the pericardium is about, one of the things is it's protecting the heart. So, you know, I mean, on some level, if somebody is saying something where they feel like emotionally closed off or something like that, rather than try to talk to them, and words are confusing, you can do some lovely work opening up this particular line of energy. So perhaps whatever is keeping the emotion out, soften a little bit, and they'll be able to feel a little bit, you know. And, you know, what makes this all work is our intention about it. You know, we're tight. And I think that's a lot of times what the meridians are. They're just a point of focus for our attention. So we can set a particular attention, you know, and do our work with that intention and to help make that manifest. And I think that's part of the work. So it brings our mind to it so that when we do the work, that it's putting that intention in. So that's pericardium. And then the heart, like I said, starts in the armpit, but we don't usually poke an armpit, okay? And then it comes right through the bicep and the tricep on the little finger side, and right up through the hand and the little finger here, okay? So I think what we'll do is just the stretches and then the yin meridians in both arms, because that'll be plenty, and then we'll do the yang meridians, because if I just say all that, not too much. Okay, so we'll just do yin.